those folks at the workplace that continues to be encouraging to me, regularly reminding me that he's praying for me, and I appreciate your support and encouragement. As for Lily, I had not met her until last Sunday. She and Marty popped into our church in Spartanburg. And even though I didn't know her, I've got some great Lily stories from Marty over these last few weeks. I've laughed at stories of Lily yanking Marty out of his Southern American culture. Stories of soaking their feet together in a warm pan of water. His introduction to authentic Chinese cuisine. And Lily trying her best to understand Marty's long Southern drawl as they talk together about their shared faith. It's actually a great picture of marriage. Two people from very, very different cultural backgrounds with somewhat different languages and very different traditions, but with a simple common bond, their faith in a very big God who supersedes all of those cultural and historical barriers. That common bond that is capable of miraculously bringing two people together as one flesh. I love the story of the first parade in Genesis chapter 2. God forms this great big receiving line, and he parades all of the animals past Adam. And Adam names the animals, squirrels and beagles and turtles. And the Bible says in Genesis 2, whatever the man called a living creature, that's what his name was. The man gave names to all the livestock and to the birds of the sea and to every wild animal. But for the man, there was no helper found for him. So the Lord caused a deep sleep to come over the man, and he slept, and God took one of his ribs and closed the flesh at that place. Then the Lord God made the rib he had taken from the man into a woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, "Finally, this one at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one will be called, whoa, man, woman, because she was taken from man." This is the reason why a man leaves his father and his mother and bonds with his wife, and the two of them become one flesh. Both the man and his wife were naked, yet felt no shame in this bond of marriage. Marty and Lily, a man leaves his father and mother and bonds with his wife because his wife is a gift to him from God himself. Marriage is God's idea. He designed it and engineered it and architected it and created it and patented it. This most beautiful and sacred and intimate of all human relationships is simply a gift to us from a loving God. It's a great picture, isn't it? At the same time, the enemy is not a fan of marriage. And while the enemy may try to convince the culture otherwise, marriage has and will always be the foundation of a strong society because that's the way God designed it. And so today, as we, family and friends, we commit to pray for you, Marty and Lily, as you begin this new marriage together. Let's pray together right now. Father, thank you for a beautiful day. Thank you for a beautiful place. Thank you, Father, for this beautiful gift that you have given to us of marriage. And I thank you for Marty and for Lily and for their faith in you. I thank you, Father, that you have brought the two of them together, and we celebrate them today as they take this step in their lives, making this vow together for the rest of their lives to live together in unity. I pray that you will bless them and will bless this day for them. May it be a great, memorable day of celebration for them. We love you, Lord, and we thank you for this time together. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen. Marty and Lily, as you know, marriage is a sacred vow before God. And it's not to be entered into lightly. And so I ask you, you're already joining right hands. Marty, I want to ask you first, will you take Lily to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together in unity with one another and with the Lord who has given you life? Will you love her, honor her, comfort her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live? Lily? will you take Marty to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together in unity with one another and with the Lord who has given you life? Will you love him and honor him and comfort him and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
So Marty and Lily are going to exchange rings today. The exchanging of rings is symbolic for a couple of reasons. The first, it's made of pure metal, symbolizing the purity and unending love that God has for both of you, and the love you have for each other. The second reason is that the ring is a circle. It has no beginning and it has no ending. And it is a symbol of the never-ending love of God and the never-ending love that the two of you have from this day forward. Marty, would you place, well, you've got her ring, would you place the ring on Lily's finger? And holding it there, look into her eyes and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Thank you.
Lily, would you take this ring?
Yes.
And put that on Marty's finger. Holding it there and looking into his eyes, would you repeat after me? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As my vow.
And with all that I am.
And all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Pray together. Thank you, Father, for this beautiful commitment, this beautiful ceremony and celebration, Lord Jesus. We just pray for Marty and for Lily in these days as they start a brand new life together, a brand new home, a brand new family. Father, doing things together for the very first time. I pray, Lord, that you will bless them and that you will favor them and that you will fill their home with laughter and with joy and with peace. And Father, I pray that they would know your presence. Lord, we love you and we thank you for what you are doing in their lives. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So Marty and Lily are going to light the unity candle. Before we started, we have the individual candles lit representing their individual lives. And they're now going to grab the individual candles and light that center candle together and extinguish their individual candle. I'm not sure if they're going to extinguish or not. Symbolizing their unity together. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Marty Parton.